this video, I'm going to be talking about biological toxins. If you've watched my overview video, I'm trying to break down the levels of toxin and detoxification so that everyone can understand what's going on and what are the basics at play. Because in today's society, we use toxins and detoxification as easy words to throw around in marketing and to sell supplements and things. And I want to make sure everyone's on the same page as far as what are the actual toxins you are exposed to, what are the ways to detoxify them. And in this one, we'll actually talk about how do you test for these toxins and how do you treat these toxins, and then very briefly about how you detoxify them. The detoxification video will be a completely separate one, and the mold one will be a completely separate one, although we will touch on it today. So in my overview video, I have talked about toxins in general, and they break down both biological and environmental toxins, and then each one goes into its subcategories. And so start with that video before you break down into this one. But this one, we're going to talk about the biological toxins. If you don't already know me, my name is Dr. Philip Oob. I'm a functional medicine doctor here in Austin, Texas, and we're going to dive into some biological toxins. So first and foremost, I like to address that even your own human body makes biological toxins. Too often we're talking about this toxic world and chemicals and vaccines and everything that's polluted out in our environment, but we forgot that our own body has detoxification processes because it creates toxins as well. Now, these are not necessarily harmful toxins, but your body's all about homeostasis, and this homeostasis word means that you need to be in balance at all times. So every hormone has a balance, and so that's one of the toxins I've listed here under human is hormones. I know it's a busy slide, so I'll try to put a zoomed in shot where you can see it. So your own body makes these toxins, one of which being hormones. Hormones always have to be in balance. You don't want too much insulin because that means you're diabetic. You don't want too little insulin because that means you're a type 1 diabetic. You want the right amount. And so for that example, that also goes for testosterone, that goes for thyroid, that goes for any hormone that your body makes. It has to be made and it has to be broken down. And that's what keeps your body in that homeostasis. At any moment that something starts to get too high, it should break it down quicker and slow down the production in order to keep things in balance. So what are some other human toxins that your body needs to take care of? CO2, carbon dioxide, that's made from making energy. I've listed mito a little further down. So the mitochondria are the things inside of your cells. They're the little battery or the powerhouse of the cell that manufactures all the energy for the cell. And so that mitochondria, anything that makes energy, makes toxic byproducts. So it makes oxygen-free radicals. It makes toxic metabolites in order to that need to be detoxified through breathing, like CO2. In the breakdown of energy, you sometimes use muscle or protein, and that makes urea. Urea has to be gotten rid of through the urine. And so all of these things are natural human toxins that we can't forget about. So if you're not taking care of your own human toxins, how can you ever expect to take care of some of these other toxins? Vice versa. If you have too many of these mold and mucosal toxins, how can you expect to take care of your own human toxins? So this is the idea behind there's only so many things you can detoxify at once. So as your liver starts to slow down because it can't handle the toxins, all the other cellular processes start to slow down as well. So you have brain fog, you have less energy, you're depressed, you start to get muscle cramps, you can't sleep. Whatever it may be, that old saying that something's got to give is the phenomenon. Whenever you can't metabolize your toxic byproduct, you can't make energy. I will use the same metaphor I use in almost all my videos about energy. If your car cannot, if your car's exhaust pipe doesn't work, if you put a sock in your exhaust pipe, your engine will only go so far before it overheats and burns up. The car engine must detoxify, and without detoxification, it can't make energy. So is your human body. So we'll keep the testing really simple because we can get lost in testing, but I want to list three main tests. And by no means are these the only tests in the world. These are just the ones that I'm currently using and would utilize at this time in my office. So the first one is called the NutriEval. That's from Genova. It goes over some of your organic acids, your mitochondrial function, vitamin levels, toxic burden, detox markers. All of those are important in assessing where the overall human is. Is it struggling to make energy? Is it struggling to detoxify? What are the gut markers like? So this NutriEval is a pretty comprehensive test. It's very, very similar to the OAT test, the organic acid test from Great Plains Labs. The organic acid test does some of the same markers, and so you can apply the same logic. I consider the OAT test a little bit better of a gut test, and the NutriEval a little bit better of a toxin detox test, although there's a lot of overlap between both of them. They're both great tests. And the next test I have on the list is just the Cleveland Heart Lab. That's the current lab we're using for our advanced markers. And so that Cleveland Heart Lab has things like Vitamins, B12, vitamin D, magnesium, ferritin, which is your iron storage, omega-3s, all the things that your body needs to operate on a regular basis to actually manufacture energy and to detoxify. So the treatment for this is actually fairly simple. Whatever, simple in this regard, it's going to get more complex, of course. But in this simplified diagram, whenever you find a deficiency, you just replace it with that vitamin or that nutrient or that food or whatever it may be. Your body, as long as it gets the right nutrients, it can handle its own detoxification processes. And some of these other things, we have to worry about the sources of these and how do we avoid it. Well, you can't avoid your human toxins. That's just part of being alive. So really all you need to do is supply the body with the right vitamins and nutrients, and it can do the rest. Now, as far as detoxification, you must breathe, you must urinate, you must sweat, you must pass stool in order to detoxify. So all of these are components in detoxification of your own human hormones. You can see I've got some other things down here, binders, methylation, glutathione, and oil pushers. And that's more, we'll talk about that more in the other biological toxins, although those are utilized in human detoxification. We'll get there.